The Kanlaon Volcano in the Philippines is at risk of soon producing a significant eruption, potentially even its first truly magmatic eruption since 1902. Now, to alleviate some fears, I am not talking about a plenian or subplenian eruption, but do consider a potential for a strong volcanian eruption with 10-kilometer-high eruption plumes to occur. However, a smaller eruption, assuming one does end up occurring due to the current unrest, is still the most likely outcome. Magma, in my opinion, is clearly at shallow depths, resulting in what has repeatedly set all-time high records in sulfur dioxide emissions at this volcano. These daily gas emission records have been repeatedly broken during the last month and most recently reached an emission of 11,556 tons a day on September 11, 2024. That is a stunningly high figure for a volcano which is not actively erupting, and such high levels indicate a likelihood of abundant magma at a depth of less than a kilometer below ground. I have received numerous first-hand and second-hand reports of concerned citizens living near this volcano on Negros Island who, for the first time in their lives, are detecting a strong and distinctive volcanic smell, specifically the rotten egg smell characteristic of hydrogen sulfide levels of between 4.7 parts per billion and 100 parts per million. While no official gas measurements of hydrogen sulfide have been made around the volcano, or if they have been made, they have not been made public, the most likely concentrations are below the 1 part per million range. Regardless, my point is that both physical evidence from instrumentation and circumstantial evidence from people support that highly unusual once-in-a-lifetime activity is occurring at the Kanlaon volcano. Alongside this, a strong degassing plume has emerged, rising a kilometer above Kanlaon's 2,465-meter or 8,067-foot-high summit crater. Volcanic earthquakes largely related to the movement of magma have jumped from a daily rate of 2 on September 5th to 37 on September 10th to 337 on September 11th. While this sudden spike in activity could be resolved with no eruption occurring, as most magmatic intrusions do fail before they reach the surface and produce an eruption, such absurdly high gas emissions make this less likely of an outcome. If we look at Kanlaon's past eruptions since 1902, they have largely been preceded by the following warning signs in the month beforehand. Multiple days with more than 10 daily volcano tectonic earthquakes, a day with more than 100 volcano tectonic earthquakes, and the occurrence of short or long-term ground deformation with the signal directly indicating the movement or subsurface buildup of magma. Well, in the last month, 8 days have had more than 10 volcano tectonic earthquakes. September 11th saw 337 volcano tectonic earthquakes occur, and separate portions of the volcano have been experiencing uplift since March 2022, 2023, and July of 2024. So, once again, the data is pointing towards the potential for an eruption to soon occur. This is why the Kanlaon volcano is currently at an alert level of 2 on a 0 to 5 scale, and why there is currently a 4-kilometer exclusion zone in place in all directions around Kanlaon's summit. Even weak phreatic eruptions can generate lethal pyroclastic flows. Any eruption, were one to occur, would probably not involve a massive catastrophic event without preceding eruptive activity. Instead, it would be probably preceded by weak phreatic eruptions with dozens of explosions occurring before any lava flow is emitted or truly magmatic eruption component occurs. I need those of you who live within a 20-kilometer radius of this volcano and those of you who live adjacent to drainages which originate from Kanlaon's edifice to pay special attention to what occurs during the next few weeks to months. Were an eruption to soon occur, pyroclastic flows, ashfall, strong gas emissions, lahars, and even viscous 10 to 40 meter high andesite lava flows have the potential to directly impact some of Negros Island's residents. I really hope that I do not have to soon give an update discussing an eruption from Mount Kanlaon, but this could soon end up occurring anyways. Please stay safe, everyone. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Killin Knot, for supporting this channel.